Man, look at this. They done did it, didn't they? Look at the set.
This is live, kid.
You know the crazy thing about this, Snoop? When I saw it, I said, like, I was going to do the highlight show. I honestly thought that we was going to do it from, like, actual Tokyo. I really did.
When I signed on, I thought I was going to be, you know what I'm saying, side by side with, you know, Mike Tirico.
You trying to say because of that, that's not what you expect to be?
I mean, he's the voice of this Olympus. I thought I was going to be sitting next to him.
That makes you feel good? Hurt my feelings like that?
I didn't try to hurt your feelings.
That makes you feel good?
Like
you proud of yourself?
Kev? Come on,
you proud of yourself hurting my feelings like that before we do our show?
I apologize. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry.
That's in four, three,
about to start.
Two.
Hey, come on. Don't mess up. Okay? Lock in.
Okay.
Mm-mm. Welcome to Olympic Highlights with Kevin Hart and Snoop Dogg. I, of course, am Kevin Hart. And the acclaimed journalist to my left in this amazing turtleneck is Snoop Dogg himself. Snoop, how you doing, man? Are you excited to be here?
Look here, Kev, I'm so excited to be here, man. You don't have no idea how much respect I got for the athletes, for the training, and the sacrifice in general.
Oh, sacrifice. That's a good word, man. You know why? Because there's so much that goes into this. I mean, when you're talking about the Olympics, you're talking about athletes that put countless hours of practice. I mean, you're talking about travel. You're talking about the time away from friends and family. There's so much that goes into this.
The time away from, you know.
What?
I feel for you, Shakira.
What are you talking about? You talking about that stuff. He talking about that stuff.
The good stuff.
You talking about that nasty stuff.
The good stuff.
You talking about that ooh-wee stuff.
Ooh-wee.
Well, Snoop, here's the good news, man. The only thing that they're testing for now is COVID. Yeah, it's a big deal now. Guys, we're going to have a blast. What we're going to do is watch a lot of these athletes, and I'm talking about some of the greatest, compete for the next 2 weeks in Tokyo.
Mm. I got one question for you, Kevin.
Yes, sir.
Why is the show called Olympic Highlights with Kevin Hart and Snoop Dogg?
Mm.
See, because alphabetically speaking, D comes before H, so D-O-double-G should be before H-A single R single T.
Well, Snoop, I'll be honest with you. I thought that I would put it in there and you never would pay it any mind. I had no idea that you would break it down like that. And now that you have, maybe we can talk to our team and see what we can change. But that was very good breakdown of how, you know, alphabetical, how it should go.
Yeah, that's my rap shit. You know, yeah, it kicks in sometimes.
I thought you would kind of just let it slide, but no. You pay attention.
Oh, yeah, I focus. Yeah.
This is a different Snoop than a turtleneck. I'll tell you that, people. Ladies and gentlemen, let's watch some highlights. This is the breakdown. After 5 long years of waiting, the Olympics kicked off Friday night with the opening ceremony. And let me tell you what, it was worth the wait. Take a look for yourselves. Wow, look at this, tap dancing.
I like that, I like that. Oh, that's sweet, the blue man showed up?
That's the blue man, those were the Olympic guys. That's what that was.
That dress was amazing.
It doesn't get any better than that. The opening ceremony is exactly what it's supposed to be, which is big, which is beautiful. I mean, so much hope, so much potential tied into it. Everyone still believes they have a shot at winning.
Yeah.
That's the beautiful thing about that moment. Everybody in that feels like I still can win. They haven't realized that some of them not even gonna get close to that podium, right? You gotta think it's 1,000 people in there. More than that, some of them gonna go home on that coach triple connecting flight, and they are going to be hurt.
Triple connection.
The triple connection.
Stop in San Antonio, then go to Shreveport, Louisiana, then fly to France, and then you go home.
Yeah, they go, they go Delaware, AC. They go Delaware, AC.
Thank you for
London.
Flying with Olympic Airlines.
That's the U.S. Some of them, man, some of them get put through the ringer.
Woo!
Snoop, for the next 2 weeks, man, these countries are going to be at each other's throats.
Yeah, but during the Parade of Nations, everyone is still a champion. No one is lost yet.
Mm-hmm.
Except for this guy who definitely looks lost.
Oh, my God. Look at this guy here.
Look at him.
If you don't know who we're talking about the weird white guy on the right. The weird white guy in the group of black people. He's
out of formation to begin with. Well, what line are you in?
He looks like a liaison. He looks like a Disney rep. You know.
Uh-oh, there go that offbeat clap.
Oh, my God. What was he doing? Nobody could flag that guy and say, get out of here, Jake. That was Jake from State Farm. Get out of here, man. You shouldn't be there, Jake.
One of these things is not like the other.
Not at all. The Parade of Nations tried something different this year by having each nation include 2 flag bearers, a man and a woman. And I'll tell you what, it was a great idea on paper, but no one could really figure out how 2 people could share 1 flag. Look and see for yourself. Look at how they're forcing themselves to share the flag. It's weird.
And look at her. She pulling. He's like, hold on, I'm trying to be on TV. I want to be on TV.
This is violent. This is stupid. Why are they trying? Why are you guys trying?
They gonna go home and argue. They fighting already. Market.
Yeah, yeah. He's a Boston Market piece of chicken. That's a great call. Mr. Boston Market Chicken
Rotisserie.
Himself. Jesus Christ. Slow down on the oil, sir. I just want to say you are doing your thing.
Thank you, kid.
No, no problem,
Thank
man.
You, kid.
This is all right.
This is fun.
We look like we belong.
That's Can, what I'm
let's
saying.
Give him a quick, just give him a quick moment of how we look.
Yeah.
It's just to show you that we you know what I mean? Like, we're prepared for the moment.
We're prepared for this, man.
I'm glad you said that, because right now I want to go into our segment. Tokyo Drip.
Ooh, drip, drip,
what
drip.
What a segment this would be. Right now, guys, I want to go over some of the fashion that we saw on display during the Parade of Champions. We'll start with the athletes from Argentina. Argentina looks like a whole country of Colin Jost. You know who Colin Jost is?
I don't know who that is if I was sitting next to him.
What do you mean? He's the white guy.
Well, I know that part.
He sits next to Michael Che. You know who he is.
I know Michael Che.
He's the white guy sitting next to him when they do the
Oh, the news broadcasting
side by side?
Okay, I know, cuz. It's my fault. All y'all look the same. My
Colin,
bad.
Well, Colin's he's a good guy. He's married to Scarlett Johansson.
What? Oh,
yes.
He came up like God.
Let's keep the fashion going. Let's get into the West African country of Burundi.
Oh, Burundi. I bet ain't none of them got no drawers on.
Oh.
I can just tell right now they walking out there with sheets, no drawers, and sticks.
Oh,
let's go.
That's what a dare. I dare anybody to go up and lift up one of them things
right,
next time.
Love lifted me
now. Just run by one of them and just go, what's under here? Just to see. Just see what'll happen. I think everybody will be shot.
Let's see how the USA team looks. Oh, that look like some Ralph Lauren. Is that what that is?
The U.S., we always do it right, man.
Okay, that's fly.
Extremely swaggy.
That's fly.
I like what they're doing with the bandanas. Some of them are putting them on their head, wrapping them around the necks, you know, giving a little thug passion.
That's
you know
what it's supposed to be. They're representing that hood shit. Yeah, you know what I mean? There's the Cayman Islands. What Olympic sport are they known for?
I would say they're known for tax evasion. That's a good one. They might not win the gold, but they'll help you hide it. Jesus Christ.
Hey, the Australian team came out looking like Girl Scouts. Check them out, Kev.
Oh, come on. Where are the cookies? Oh, this is nothing.
They got all of them looking like it, even the men. Look at this.
I mean, the shorts are hemmed to perfection. Come on, above the knees. Next country.
Saudi Arabia. Oh, no, I ain't saying nothing
you
about
shut
them.
Shut your mouth. Nothing to say
I'm not
here.
Even looking at the women. I'm
no,
over
no, no, bro. You better turn your damn head.
I see
head.
My head over there.
Are they off the screen yet? You look.
Did they leave yet?
I ain't going to look first. You look.
You look.
I ain't looking.
I ain't playing with them over there.
Hey, somebody
look.
Better give me a sign. Is Saudi Arabia off the screen?
Clear.
Okay, we are clear.
Rightio.
We escaped that one. That could have got ugly.
Man.
Technically, the opening ceremony kicks off the Olympics, but the U.S. women's soccer team actually kicked off last Wednesday against Sweden.
But didn't nobody tell them?
No, they did not. The U.S. lost in a major upset to Sweden, 3-0. We scored no goals at all. Look at this.
Looks
Gus.
Like the Swedish women went to IKEA and built themselves a better team.
Snoop, you ain't lying. But the U.S. isn't out of it. They came back with vengeance and destroyed New Zealand in game two. It seemed like everyone on our team got a goal. We even got two from New Zealand themselves. So to help them keep their heads in the game, I think Coach Snoop's to give them a little pep talk. Go ahead, Snoop.
Ladies, first of all, you guys beat the New Zealand team 6-1, which gives you a 2-goal advantage in the group standings. Y'all can do this. And if y'all do this, I'm gonna make sure the Olympic Committee give y'all some more money, because I don't appreciate the way y'all ain't being paid for the way y'all play. Then you got the Australians, right? They only, what, ranked 9th in the world? You guys won 4 gold. 4 times. Before, and you're gonna do it again. Don't play with them. Get them out the way, take care of business, kick the balls around until you get the balls in the net. And once you put the balls in the net, game's over. Let's go, girls.
Well, somebody shut the front door and call me Steve and go get my coat, because that's what I call motivation. The U.S. women's softball team, well, guess what, Snoop? They can't stop winning.
Now the count 0-2. And there is a shot. Extra bases, perhaps. Heading for second is Groenwagen. The throw to the plate and the tag by Monroe. And she is out at home.
Great highlight, great call. Let's play it back and let me give it a shot. I tell you what, Snoop, this reminds me of when I played softball in my church league. We were down 3-0 to the pastors, right?
Ooh.
It was the pastors at the time. I was a deacon. You know I was a deacon?
Deacon
I was
Hart.
The youngest deacon at my church.
Deacon Hart.
6 years old. I couldn't hold the plate because it got heavy for me, so my arms would shake. But I knew all the things that I was supposed to say. Bottom line, playing in the church league is good for you as a young child, because nobody can suck. They just, they praise everyone.
It's encouragement.
Oh, look at that boy. He's not going to grow to be over 5'2", but the Lord got something different
God
in store
has
for him.
A plan for him.
Yeah, that's all it is. They made me feel good about myself. We lost to the pastors, too, Snoop. Mm. Pastors were cheaters, to be honest with you. A lot of dishonesty goes on in the church league. Let's get into the U.S. men's gymnastic teams, man. They're training hard. Training very hard to bring home the gold. And guess what? Snoop, we got some behind-the-scenes footage of them at practice. Let's take a look at this.
Okay, baby powdered up, though.
Yeah, yeah.
Why'd he put him in his pits?
I don't know. I'm glad he smelled good, though, because I can't stand no musty weightlifter.
Oh, my God. Yeah, look at this footage. Look what we got. Their feet are in the buckets, as you can see. They're putting baby powder on the bottom of their feet, as well as their armpits, calves. This is, you won't see this anywhere else.
A baby powder bath.
That just happened.
I've heard of a bubble bath, not a baby powder bubble bath. That's a baby powder bubble bath.
A baby powder bubble bath.
Yeah, that was.
They got it here first, Snoop. They got it here first.
Say that. Say
We're
that.
Doing our job. That is it for the breakdown. Please give me my little screen, thingamajiggy. There it is. Look at that, Snoop.
Woo. Fly. Toast to the boogie.
Oh, man, toast to the boogie. All right, somebody get my suit and put a fork in it, because I don't want it.
Mm.
Guys, that got weird at the end, but it will get weirder. We'll be right back with more after this. Welcome back to the Olympic Highlights with myself and Snoop Dogg here on Peacock. One of the highlights of Parade of Nations was once again PETA. For those who do not know, PETA is a shirtless Tonga guy who brought his A game and oiled up pets to Tokyo for his third Olympics. Look at PETA right now. Look at him.
Sweet Pete.
Huh? Look at him, huh?
He oiled down.
Oiled down to the nines.
He was greasy as a bag of chicken. He's joining us live from Tokyo. I may butcher your name, but I'm gonna give it a shot. Welcome, PETA Taafa Tufuyi.
Nice.
PETA T in the house.
Nice. Nice.
PETA T.
Nice. That was good, Snoop.
Dofo Tofo. They we didn't like teach this. Us that in school. We didn't learn names like that. So tell us the proper pronunciation of your name.
Hey guys, pleasure to be here. The proper pronunciation is PETA Taafa Tofua.
Yeah, I knew it.
I knew it.
I said it.
I knew it.
I said that.
I could have bet the money I would have got it right. I should have bet the money in the back. Say it one more time for me, PETA.
Taafa Tofua.
PETA, let's cut to the chase, man. The oil, whose decision was it? Was this just a you thing? Was it a suggestion from the outside?
It's coconut oil, but this is something that's used all throughout the Pacific. So whenever we do traditional dances or anything, we cover ourselves in oil.
Nice.
And so I didn't think it would be that big a deal, but it turns out a lot of other nations hadn't seen that being done before in terms of a traditional outfit.
Yeah, they do it here in that place. What's
in
it called?
The gym.
The strippers.
Yeah, the
male
cheetahs.
Exotic dancers. That's where they probably stay true to.
Chippendales.
There you go. That's the Chippendales. They have been a part of the coconut oil culture for quite some
time. It highlights your triceps and biceps, and it just puts them on a different level. Like, we use baby oil.
Yeah. Let me tell you something.
Ain't that special?
I use baby oil, and let me tell you the reaction I get from my lady when I do. You might as well cancel Christmas
Hello.
If I come out
See
with
what
baby
I'm
oil.
When you shining
okay?
like that?
Hey, let me tell you something.
Shining leads to grinding.
Hey, let me tell you something, PETA. I know exactly the reaction from that. PETA, number three for you. How does that feel? That's a big deal, man. Is it better the third time? Are you just as nervous as you were the first? Or is it more of a smooth sailing system for you now?
Each time is a little bit different, but also very special. I mean, we had the opportunity to carry the flag, and I just appreciate having the opportunities that I've been given to take the nation to the world.
PETA, this is your second Summer Olympics competing at Taekwondo. When is your first match?
My first match is on Tuesday, and I'm fighting the world-ranked number one. So it's the big, tough Russian guy.
So this dude from Vanuatu, he stole your look this year. I want to know who wore it better.
You son of a bitch.
He stole his style.
He got some nerve coming out there oiled up after you did it.
What he got on flip-flops from the 70s beach day.
First of all, I think this is PETA's first time seeing this footage. She had no idea. PETA, did you know that this guy did that, PETA?
I came in barefoot, so it's not exactly the same, but...
See, he came in barefoot. That's gangster. That's original tribal. You understand me? You true to your roots when you did that.
Very awkward bumping into another man oiled up at an event where nobody else is. That's extremely awkward.
Were you on your way to the bodybuilding contest?
Yeah, it's like when you thought that was your look, and then you look over and somebody else is doing the same thing. Hey, man, what you doing?
Hey.
This is my gig. You can't show up oiled up like that today. This is my thing, man. And they get into an argument about it.
And they start pushing each other and slipping and sliding off of it. PETA, I want to ask you, is that a Tempur-Pedic bed that you're sitting on?
Good question.
Because I know they're taking care of y'all in the Olympics.
Snoop, this is a cardboard bed. It's actually made from cardboard, and it's going to be recycled after the games.
Yeah, let me sneak a peek. Let me see how y'all living. Let me see how y'all boss balling over there in the Olympics.
Recycled after the game.
Let me see how y'all boss balling over there. Let me see.
That's your cardboard? Yeah.
That's the bed.
And then going underneath.
Oh, no, cuz. Look at this.
Come on, Olympics.
Y'all come wrong on for that.
The man is, he's coming out with the flag.
I'm saying, you gonna mess the bed up with all that oil. That oil gonna mess that cardboard up.
That's gonna seep right through that carpet. That oil get on that cardboard, it's a wrap, Peter.
You gonna be backspinning and doing all kind of breakdance moves.
Right now, because of what you do and the way you do it, does this make you like an international sex symbol?
Wherever I go, I always hear rumors. The people say, hey, that guy's almost as good looking as Kevin Hart.
Nice.
I think that actually puts me up there somewhere.
Pete, you got swag, dog.
Yeah, no, I like Pete.
We all know about you here, but have people in Tonga ever heard about me and Kevin?
Ah, that's a good question. Do the people in Tonga know about us? Are we big over there in Tonga?
You guys are huge, and I say this no joke, absolutely. Kevin, everyone's seen your movies. You bring so much joy, so much comedy to, like, the deepest corners of the Pacific over in Tonga. And Snoop, we've been dancing to your music under coconut trees since forever.
No, Snoop, don't. Snoop, I don't think that's what they do to you. No, Snoop, that's a crip. They're not doing that dance, Snoop. They're not doing that dance. He's saying that they're having a good time.
Are they doing the tribal dance?
Yeah. No, Snoop, you can't do that. Oh. Okay, Peter, it's late there, man. We know that you got to get some rest. Unfortunately, you got to do it on a cardboard box.
They got them blow-up mattresses out there. I think they got it for like $19.99.
I thought you was going to say blow-up doll. I was going to say, we got to go. We got to cut it out.
He don't need that kind of love in his life. We need the love going to bed.
Good luck, man. Good luck, Peter. Honestly, man, we're wishing you nothing but the best.
We're rooting for you, Pete. Get that gold medal, baby. We're rooting for you. Let's go, Pete.
From me to you.
I appreciate it, and I can't wait for you guys to come visit Tonga sometime. We're waiting for you.
And make sure y'all got some of that Tongan tree for me when I get there.
And hey, at this point in time, man, put a shirt on. You did your job, okay? Like, now it's time to get dressed. All right, guys, we will be right back, man. We got more highlights coming from the Olympics with myself and Snoop Dogg right here on Peacock. You do not want to miss what we're going to say next. Please stick around.
I love doing this shit even though it ain't nothing in it.
Oh, no, Snoop, you don't do that.
Welcome back. You know what I like about the Olympics? It's how they always changing it up. Make a slight change, you change the whole game. Like basketball, add 3x3, it's a whole different game.
Complete different game.
Volleyball, add a beach. Beach volleyball.
Oh my God.
Tennis, add a table. Table tennis. You see me working?
I see you working. Keep staying there.
Boxing, turn up the heat. Hot boxing.
Yo, I'm not really sure how that one works.
So it's maybe recreational, Kev. And every time I do get wrecked.
Okay. All right. I'm picking up what you're laying down. What you're saying is you basically add a word, you change the sport.
That's what I'm saying.
All right, okay, like this. So you got mountain biking.
Mm-hmm.
Mountain Dew biking.
Now we got sponsorships.
All right, deadlifting. Dead body lifting, right?
That's a little dark, but it's a team sport.
Yeah, you see what I'm saying? Shooting. Right?
That's a white man's sport.
No. Shooting dice.
Now that's for the community.
Hello. Okay. There's a whole new world of sports. All you gotta do is add a word. I wanna hear what y'all think. Do me a favor, get on Twitter right now and get creative. Add one word. Let us know what change sport you'd like to see. Use the hashtag, add a word, change a sport. It's that simple. Look, there's a lot of sports in the Olympics, and some of them are actually tough to understand, especially when you don't know the athletes or the lingo.
Yeah, so we're here to hook you up with some, you know, key intel so you can sound like you know what you're talking about.
I like that. This is your Olympic cheat sheet. Let's start with archery. The defending world champion for the U.S. men's team is Brady Ellison, a.k.a. the Arizona Cowboy, a.k.a. the Prospector.
A.K.A. Robin never been to the hood.
Damn sure hasn't. While cheering on the U.S. archery team, make sure you yell things like this. That fletching is on point.
That fletching is on point.
Yeah, but you gotta tell them what it means, Snoop.
That means the back of your arrow looks fly as hell.
Fly as hell. Here's another one. The knocking point almost got ruined by the quiver.
The knocking point almost got ruined by the quiver.
Yeah, but Snoop, tell them what it means so they understand it.
That means that the arrow bag that messed up our tip.
You can't mess up the arrow bag. You mess up the arrow bag, you done messed up our tip. Don't nobody want their tip messed up. Don't do that.
I'm shivering because you didn't touch my quivering.
You got me shivering. Now what I'm supposed to do? My finish is all shaky. So that's your Olympic cheat sheet. You heard it here first. Welcome back. Little piece of information for you people. U.S. Rowing has 37 athletes competing in 9 events at this Olympics. So far, we're off to a good start. Here's a look at Kara Kohler and her heat for the women's single sculls. Take a look. Breathe.
Come on, rep Cali.
Breathe.
Represent Cali.
Breathe, Kara.
Bring it in.
He, ho, he, ho, he, ho.
Heat number one.
Go, Kara. Now, Snoop and I, well, we don't know a whole lot about Olympic rowing, so what we decided to do was bring in somebody who does. Liz Smith, the assistant rowing coach from USE.
SC, fight on.
Fight on, SC. She's here to give us the rowdown. Welcome, Liz. How are you?
I'm doing well. Thank you guys for having me.
Oh, man, thank you for being had.
So, Liz, what's the most important thing that we need to know as far as about rowing?
Rowing is a full-body workout. It's one of the fastest-growing sports in the United States, and it's actually a sport that most people don't start until they get to college.
Nice. It's very nice, Liz. I like it. I like it.
Full-body sport, huh? I like that.
Full-body sport. Liz, question for you. What does it take to probably get to the Olympics in rowing? Give me a breakdown of that world. What does it take?
Absolutely. So a lot of time, a lot of sacrifice. Mm-hmm. Most of the women have been training for decades. Mm-hmm. I trained for a number of years, got to represent the United States in a world championship.
Give me some.
Yeah. Never quite made it to the Olympics, but have been fortunate enough to witness some of that sacrifice and hard work in person. We have 2 USC rowing alums.
Woo!
In Tokyo, Chloe Brew for Great Britain.
Go, and Chloe!
And Ida Gorch Jacobsen for Denmark.
Let's go, Ida!
Yeah.
Hello.
One question. What makes someone a good rower?
Sorry to say, but a lot of times rowers have really long legs. Really long torso, really long arms. So, Snoop, this might be for you.
So, like, if me and Snoop were to compete, how far should we go?
How about we say a minute race?
A minute
all
race.
Out.
All
a right. Minute.
A minute race.
Cool.
You heard what she said, Snoop? I'm about to kick your ass. Good luck, Snoop.
All right, don't forget to use your leg. Kevin's off to a pretty good start, Snoop.
I'm
you're going to have to catch
ass.
Up
Say
here.
Say what it is, Liz.
I don't know you are. You're kicking
what am
his
I
ass.
Doing I'm a machine.
There you go,
me.
Snoop.
Liz.
Oh, yeah, Kevin, you've been practicing.
Liz,
I
don't know if they have sex symbols in this sport, but I feel like I could be one. Can you get a good look at my form, please?
You could be the first one.
I don't give a fuck about your form. I'm going to walk your little ass down.
Brother, I'm locked in.
Snoop's making a move, though. I don't know.
If you can
Kevin,
see
don't
my
let
face.
Him catch you.
What are you talking about? I'm like 28 meters ahead. I'm gonna be honest with you, Liz. I'm getting
breathe.
Fuck breathing. I'm smoking.
I'm tired, cuz.
All the way through, all the way to the finish line.
Hey, Snoop.
I love digging.
Snoop, I'm tired, cuz.
Well, I ain't low. Get the 300.
That's it. Here
get
we go.
The 300. Fuck that.
Oh, man, we have
5 seconds.
300.
4.
Oh,
3.
My form
2.
300.
1. That's it. Done.
Woo. Fuck out of here.
We're good.
Nice job.
Oh, my God.
All right. It was pretty close, Snoop, but I think Kevin got you.
Well, I mean, I guess I need to holster it.
Bring that podium out here, man.
Huh?
One thing we're not going to do is be sore losers.
Nice.
This is the American way. We win with pride and we lose with pride. I'd like to present Kevin with the award for the fastest time in rowing. Congratulations.
You a real one, cuz. That's our show, guys. Success is in me, so it's in you. Do me a favor, make sure you check back with us on Peacock. We'll be covering all the excitement at the Tokyo Olympic Games. The good, the bad, and everything in between. And remember, guys, don't be good, be great. Come on in, Snoop, give a wave goodbye, man. One time to the people. There it is. Ha, ha, ha. You ain't never seen this. Not when doing the Olympics. He just crip walked on y'all punk asses. All right, we'll see y'all when we see you. That's it. Be great. Peace.
See you.
What's going on, people? I am Kevin Hart, a.k.a. Mr. Comedic Rockstar. This is season 2 of Cold as Balls. The tub is colder, and my balls are bigger, too. Look, I got 2 big balls.
Oh, yeah.
I'm on your turf.
How are you, sir?
How are you doing?
I'm good, man. Whoa, what's under there, Skip? What's under there? What
do you know? You want me to take this off?
Yeah, Skip, we got to get in the cold tub. Of course I do. What the f*** is going on here? Kevin, I thought you were in shape, man. Skip, let me find out you're on some goddamn PEDs or something. I can have you checked. God damn it, Skip!
You gonna make me get in this?
Yes, Skip, we're getting in the tub, and then you and I are having a conversation. You're on my turf. My rules today, Skip!
You are on a supreme disadvantage.
Just sell our Here we go. I put you in the cold water because then this makes you uncomfortable. And at your most uncomfortable level, information flies out.
Then I might lose my first debate of my life.
This is it. This is it. Mm-hmm. Welcome to another episode of Cold Balls. I am your host, the Kevin Hart. And I'm with Skip Bayless, the man, the myth, the legend.
No myth. Just legend.
Just legend. Mm-hmm. Oh, I can't wait. Thank you for coming on, first of all.
You know, you're legendary now. You sabotage your own basketball team, the Philadelphia 76ers. You should be banned from going to sitting courtside at any of their games. You realize what you did to Dwayne Wade. You ignited him, and you lost the game at home?
Well, first and foremost, Skip, I wasn't guarding Dwayne Wade, okay? I am this generation's Spike Lee. I'm the mouth on the side.
Yeah, but Spike Lee is harmless, and you are going for the throat.
I'm a dog.
You are a dog, and you bit him.
Why is this the career that Skip Bayless chose?
Frustrated high school athlete.
Okay.
First day of my sophomore year, a journalism teacher said, I want you to write me a one-page book report so I can see if any of you can write. I'd never tried to write in my life. So, of course, I chose a sports book. I handed it in. She said, you are coming into journalism. You're going to write me a sports column.
She chose your career path.
Yeah, she did. I actually ripped my high school baseball coach in a column in the school paper while I was playing on the team.
That's
me.
Now, here's what some people would say, Skip. You don't do it. You can't do it. My question to you, do you feel that level of frustration from you and your sports past?
I can debate football with anybody. Right now, I debate with Shannon Sharp. He's in the Pro Football Hall of Fame.
Come on, Skip.
He has three Super Bowl rings.
Skip, I'm on them black
and miles.
And
he doesn't know more football than I know.
Skip, you know I'm on them black and miles, Skip.
Mm-hmm. That's the guy.
That's the guy. Come on now, Skip.
I've heard my whole career. You didn't play, so you don't know. Wrong. Who is the worst GM in pro basketball right now?
The worst
one? Worst team builder. The worst owner-operator in maybe all of sports. It is the greatest player in the history of sports. Michael Jordan. I found that the better you were as a player, the worse you are at seeing who can play and can't play. Kevin Hart had a genius for comedy. You have a real genius for extemporaneous, like
off the cuff. It's a great word.
Okay, am I right?
Jesus Christ.
Okay, am
Where'd
I right?
Where'd you pull that from?
It's a gift. And yet you had to go up and fail on stage, so you knew what it took. Okay, I failed at sports. I know what it takes. So Kevin Hart, let me ask you this.
Go ahead.
Who is the genius behind your Philadelphia Eagles Super Bowl championship team? Do you know?
Willis Jeffrey.
No, it wasn't Willis Jeffrey. It was Howie Roseman. He's the GM.
That's what I forgot. Howie.
Howie Roseman didn't play a lick of any high school sport. How did he figure that out? He learned it from the ground up.
All right, Skip, let's start with something simple. Why are you here? This is for athletes.
I think I'm more of an athlete than Kevin Hart is. What do you do? Don't you run? Don't you run distance? I read that you ran. What do you
do? You just said, what do I do?
Yeah.
The question is, what don't I do, Skip?
Yeah. Okay, when we're finished here, you want to go out and race? 3 miles? 6 miles? 9 miles? I'm good.
Skip, don't threaten me with a good time.
Huh? A good time?
You got a lot more life to live. Don't have me go out there and kill you by taking your heart rate up.
Okay.
What do you run on average? What do you do? What are you running right now?
I run about 8 miles a day.
In the morning or evening?
I run in the morning. I run at 2:30 in the morning, Pacific time. How about that?
What time do you go to bed?
I go about 9.
Do you go back to sleep after you?
No, I got a show to do.
Well, after hearing that, I need to do the intro all over again. I'm Kevin Hart, I'm the host of Coldest Balls, and I'm here with a freak of nature. I'm here with goddamn Skip Bayless. I will take you up on your run.
I'll be there. You want me to run barefooted?
What in the white man just happened?
I don't know.
What just happened?
I don't know.
Who don't need shoes? All right, Skip, in the water, me and you right now. Let's go. You owe me. You got it. There you go. Man,
get in.
I am. This is my show.
Oh,
I do it at my pace.
I gotta get to the gym.
There you go.
This is wicked.
I got him uncomfortable. Now it's time to ask the hard-hitting question. Why do you hate LeBron?
I like LeBron.
You hate LeBron?
I do not. I think he's actually a very nice guy. In fact, I think he's too nice of a guy.
Okay.
You know, I wish he had a little more basketball killer in him. I don't think he has enough.
Hey, damn it.
Why don't you get down in the...
Skip, don't worry about my tub.
Okay.
It's okay. Worry about your tub.
Okay.
Where I'm from, you get killed from pointing at people's tubs.
Yeah.
Ain't that right? Huh? What'd I say about not backing me up when I do stuff like that? Whenever I come to you, it's for the black backup. I told you that.
Wait, is he real?
Yes, he's real.
Oh. It just turns my stomach when all these blind witnesses, like, try to delude themselves and the basketball public into believing that LeBron James is better than Michael Jeffrey Jordan. Who would win a one-on-one game between those two?
Michael Jordan's 85!
No, in their prime.
In Michael Jordan's prime, nobody beats Michael Jordan because he's Michael Jordan.
He's a killer.
What do you think, Kobe Bryant? Where's Kobe Bryant?
I'd put him... He's in my top 10.
What the f***?
Huh? Top 10?
What kind of shit is that?
There's Shaquille O'Neal, there's Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, and there's Magic Johnson.
Skip, did you play basketball?
Yeah, I played in high school.
You played in high school?
Yeah, when I was 15, this is Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. You can laugh if you want, but Blake Griffin came from there. He's a pretty good basketball player, right?
Yeah, I know Blake.
So, I go to a big basketball clinic, a week-long clinic.
Clinic?
Kids from all across Texas and Oklahoma.
A clinic? Were you sick?
Yeah, I was sick, and my game was really sick at this point, and I was the MVP, and it was in the Oklahoma City paper. You can look it up.
The Oklahoma City paper? What the f*** is that? Skip, you're a level above me. You take the stool out. I'm sitting on my stool right now.
One, just pull
two,
it out.
Three, get loose now. Oh, it takes two to make a... Shoot, here we go. Yeah, I'm in. Y'all see this? This is good for me. Oh. Season 2. Here we go. All right. Okay, there you go. Thank you, white hand.
Why aren't you in?
I'm in right now. Here's my thing. If you play basketball, how come we don't see these stats? I want to know what you did in high school.
But in basketball, the coach despised me. And I sat that bench a lot because he just did not like my style. But
this,
you know how it goes.
We're getting somewhere.
Yeah.
What was your average, Skip?
I averaged, I think I got in like 1.4. I told you, I barely even shot. But any day, anytime you want to go play one-on-one, I'm good. Because
Skip,
I can play.
I kick your ass. I'm really getting to the root of something. It's a lot of anger from Skip's athletic pass, okay? And he takes it out on some of these basketball guys.
I do not take it out. Look, LeBron James plays no defense anymore. This is second level. You'll just freak out at this stat because it won't compute in your frozen brain at this point. But do you realize in what are called defensive win shares, which is individual defensive ranking, LeBron James ranks 309th in the whole NBA. There are like 500 players. He's 309th.
What
he guards nobody.
What did LeBron do to Skip? We're going to get to the bottom of this.
Am I not telling the truth?
No, you're
Help
not
me
telling
out. Am
the
I
truth.
Not telling the truth?
You're not telling
yes,
the truth.
Yes, you know I am, Kevin.
You have very strong opinions. They don't make you the most liked person in the world.
Yeah.
There's a high volume of people that go, man, Skip. Okay?
Now,
granted,
sure they do.
I'm not one of the people. Mm-hmm. I love you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? The world doesn't. I do.
Mm.
Nobody else does except me. I'm the only person you got. When did you make the decision to embrace that?
I'm a truth teller. I couldn't live with myself. I couldn't look myself in the mirror if I didn't tell the truth. And LeBron James is a poor free throw shooter. Do you ever hear that from Kevin Hart? Nope, you do not, because he's friends with LeBron. He might be the best role model we have in sports. LeBron's a good father and seems like he's a good husband. I don't know about
that. What do you mean seems? He is a good husband.
Like it seems like.
What the
as a husband.
See what I'm saying? It's something underneath this. I never hear you say nothing bad about the Spurs. I wonder why.
I love the Spurs. Yeah,
and that's why
I've been loving them since the
80s. You don't ever say nothing bad about Pop.
How about Manu Ginobili? There's a guy who can play.
See, nothing. Nothing.
Clutch gene?
You know what I don't like about Manu?
No.
That little hole in the back of his head. I wish he would cut all his hair off.
He should.
That's right, Manu. If you listen to me, it's time to let it go.
He's let go most of it.
No, he's not letting it go. It's leaving with or without him. What do you feel about Kawhi right now?
I feel that he didn't live up to being the face of the franchise that Tim Duncan was for all those great dynastic years. And he exaggerated an injury all year, and now I'm done with it.
How do you know that?
I just know. I talk to people. I talk to the doctor who examined him.
You can do that? You got that type of pull, Skip?
I got that kind of pull with that team. You know what? They told me no knee damage, no structural damage.
So you think that he just doesn't want to be at the franchise anymore?
I think he doesn't, and I'm done with him, and they should trade him and get the most back they can get. You want him to come to Philadelphia? Give us Embiid, and we'll be just fine.
I'm not giving you nothing.
Yes, you are.
Okay? I'm not giving you no Embiid. Embiid is there.
So now that I'm completely frozen, let me ask you some questions about me. Where did I go to college?
Ohio.
Ohio?
You was in Ohio
State.
What? Hold on,
wait. I went to Vanderbilt University, the best school in America.
Are you and Stephen A. still cool since
we
the
are
culture?
From the heart. Brother from another mother.
Yeah.
Close friend. And he never came close to winning a debate against me. I am a nice guy at heart.
Well.
So, do you realize you could do sports debate? Because you're quick, you're funny, so you should do it.
I'm going to wait till I get to that age where I don't want to move, like your age. Then I'm like, now it's time to sit down behind a desk and just be old, you know? I don't want to do the old stuff while I'm still young. But you, that's why I love you so much, because you're like, where's my coffee?
So when I said all that nice stuff to you, I thought you were just gonna let me go and the interview was gonna end, but now I think I'm just gonna have to get out anyway.
All right. Well, yeah, okay. I was gonna wrap it up anyway. I was about to do I do a nice little thing the way I wrap up the shows here. That's been another episode of Cold as Balls. I'm your host, Kevin Hart. And listen, this is what's yours. We're wrapping it up. You just heard me say I'm wrapping it up. You paying for that. You gonna pay for that ice. That's coming out your check. Cause that could have went to the next episode. So now who lost?
Hi, I'm Kevin Hart. And unless you hate laughter, click and subscribe. And if you do hate laughter, then you're a monster.
You have an exclusive announcement.
I do have an announcement. Okay, this is actually breaking news right
breaking.
Now. Breaking news, and I chose to do it here. Despite your choice of bad suits, I chose. You see how fast it came? Yeah.
Steven uses a lot of the big words. I don't really think he knows the definition of a lot of these words, but he throws them out at great points to make him come off as an educated man.
Such as?
Yeah. Well, I've heard Steve use words like despicable. He used it wrong a couple times. He was like, listen to me, Skip. You have no despicable timing. I was like, what? What
is that? Where'd that go?
Yeah, definitely wasn't supposed to be there.
Talking about he going to take my job. What you know?
Well, all I got to do is point to myself and talk loud and say a bunch of words that doesn't make any sense. That's all I gotta do. And let me tell you something, Skip. Okay, I'm not gonna talk about the samarity of this man and the samarity that he does.
I gotta ask you a question. The hat, it's one thing to wear the hat backwards. Do you have an afro under that or something? It looks very, very high.
Okay. I'll tell you what. That's none of your damn business, okay? Whatever's going on up under my hat is none of your business. The only information that you need to know is that I don't have a mushroom on the top of my head like you. That's right, Stephen A. I have a cut from this year, all right? From this era, from this generation.
Why don't you just admit to the public and to America that you got that from listening to me? Because that's what I've been saying all week.
Well, Stephen, I'm not going to do that. What I'm going to admit is that you need the rest of your mustache back. That's what I'm going to admit. Okay, that's what I'm going to admit. I don't know what he did up here. But I want you to grow the rest of that. There's too much space in between here.
Kevin Hart is here. Oh, look at this with a special birthday gift just for Stephen A. Oh, this is amazing. A Tebow jersey.
Tebow jersey.
I bought you guys gifts for his birthday, too.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, I got you guys some cool stuff. You guys know I own headphones, so that's for you guys.
Oh, this is amazing.
Yeah, I got real.
Him. I love
that's
it.
You guys.
Look
music,
at this.
What?
Music headphones.
Loving this. Awesome. I love
Thank
this.
You.
A smart headphone.
And I travel so much, so these will be great for me.
It's like perfect. The smartest headphone that you can get.
Thank
right
you, brother.
Now.
Appreciate it.
That's for you guys on his birthday.
Yes.
So the way I did
what?
That.
What? You brought them headphones, and you brought me a damn Tebow jersey?
Stop over-talking him, okay? Stop, because that's not fair to Skip.
Really?
He don't do it to you.
So you can't... He doesn't do it to me.
See,
he doesn't do it to me.
He has nothing to say.
Let me finish. You know, and then he starts going in his soliloquy, and it doesn't matter what he sees.
Soliloquy was not... You didn't have to say soliloquy right there.
But it did fit.
What?
But why did you use it?
What is it?
What?
Because that's how I talk.
See, in the morning,
that's how I talk.
He wakes up and there's somebody that gives him seven words that he has to use in that day.
Actually, I give myself seven.
Soliloquy was a word that he had to use today.
I read the dictionary every day.
I'm so sick of you, man. Dude, let me tell you something. You don't commendamize nothing around here. Those are things that I've read about my city that until this day affect me. That you did.
What?
You wrote those things.
Why are you lying?
You wrote those things.
I did.
Eagles don't have wings. You wrote those things.
I did say that.
Why don't they just clip them? You said those things.
I did say that.
Huh?
How did you find that?
You said those things.
That was a long time ago I wrote that article.
The city of brotherly love should be stepbrothers and sisters. They don't love each other. You said that.
I did say that.
You said all those mean things about my city.
I didn't know you knew that.
But now we are flying. Oh, ah! Oh, ah!
Oh, ah! Question. Do you guys have a problem with you saying these comments?
I do. I'm trying to figure out.
I want you to lower your voice. Lower your voice. You're not talking to her. You're going to give me the respect that I deserve. Don't talk to me like I'm a man. Go ahead.
I have a problem with what he said. I'm trying to figure out how in God's name.
I'm done with you, Steve. Max.
Well. People might walk up to you occasionally, and they might want to just take a picture with you and say, congratulations, great work.
Mm-hmm.
With me, they want to debate.
Mm.
My life is harder.
Well, Steven, here's what I want you to realize. A, you're lying. Nobody comes up to you. Okay? Stephen A. Smith does not have one fan. Not one. There's never been a request for a picture. There's never been a request for a debate. You are snap, you're snap finger famous. That's the guy, what's the guy that's on the guy that's on the thing, on the ESPN thing? That's what they do.
Have you gone to a Clippers game this year?
I've gone to several Clippers games.
How come you haven't mentioned them?
Well, because A, you didn't give me a chance to cut me off.
No, you didn't.
I wasn't done.
You
stopped me and then you started doing some stuff. I said there's several teams. Within those several teams, the Clippers was in that. You would know that if you knew about this world, you would know that. That's what I meant, Steve. Okay? What you do is assume. That's your problem. You assume. The Clippers are playing great basketball. And I think that the Clippers are at a great place right now. You're a bully with a capital B. You come here and you bully people with words that we don't understand. Half that stuff ain't even in a dictionary.
Excuse me. That would be him.
You got the.
That would be him.
You.
That would be him. That's not me. Listen, I've got nothing on him.
You're looking at a player that galossizes.
What? What did you say?
That would be him.
He galossizes, and that makes him a traumatical disastercation.
What? You're accustomed to negativity. Not me. I'm accustomed to positivity.
Really?
I'm accustomed to positive responses. I'm accustomed to loving environments. When I step here, there's a cloud. There's always a cloud over here, and you create that cloud.
Me?
You bring that stormy cloud. Rain, thunder, blah, 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 blah. Negative. I come here with a different energy, man, and I want to tell you, brother, you're special. You're special, and you're going to be somebody. Okay? You two disgust me. I'm going to come out and say it. You know nothing about sports. I sit in my bed and watch you guys talk about nothing every morning. Do you know how upset it makes me to hear you guys go back and forth?
You know what I know? Mm-hmm.
What do you know?
I know that an MVP is somebody that doesn't score 5 points a game. I know that much. I know that much.
What Steve Smith does on a consistent basis.
Are you disrespecting me?
You just yap.
Why are you disrespecting me?
You constantly yap, and I'm sick of it.
So?
This is your cupcake. I'm sick of it.
Oh!
Sick of your yapping.
I know sports.
Okay.
Like, you have no idea how well versed I am in this, man. You think you get to be a two-time MVP for fake, for nothing?
Uh-huh.
Absolutely.
You are ridiculous.
You are ridiculous.
Steve, I can do this, okay?
Uh-huh. I'm not sure.
Steve, I will take these notes.
Wait.
I can do this, Steve.
Okay, all you do is sit here and eat your little cupcakes, and I'm sick of it. Cupcake number two, ruin. What now? Zoom in.
A tear will fall down my eye and spell Foles when Foles wins this Super Bowl. It's going to spell Foles. You know why? Because I understand what the man went through, and I love history. And you're about to see history. That's why I'm here, to witness history. Fly, Eagles, fly! That's how I feel, Stephen A. Smith.
Molly, I think it's time for a commercial.
Well, you go to commercial.
I will go to commercial.
What's your
I
best part
that.
About Kevin?
Why don't you fly to
about
commercial?
Kevin did on
I have four MVPs. So
four?
I have four of them. I'm a four-time MVP. So if you want to talk to me about my career in basketball, how about we pick a season? Because I got four fantastic ones. And as a GOAT, the greatest of all time when it comes to celebrity basketball games, you should respect me and you should put respect on my situation. If you're not going to do that, then you don't talk about it at all.
Where were you last year when the Eagles stunk?
Oh, I'm
Where
sorry.
Were you? I couldn't find you. I was
that's
looking for you. I couldn't find you.
Oh, that's
I couldn't
right.
find you anyway. You're too busy.
That's
but,
right.
But now they got a little, they went in a few games and here you are.
That's right, because you speak
you
about
year?
The Knicks. Because I hear you talk about the Knicks all the time.
Yes, I do.
No, you don't. Who speaks up on the team's behalf when your team is losing? There's nothing to talk about. So as a sports fan, if you got nothing to say, you don't say it at all. Right now, guess what? My birds are flying. That's what we doing. Soaring. So guess what I'm going to do? I'm going to talk. I bleed Philadelphia.
Man is giving you the business on your birthday, Stephen A. Smith.
You know what? Another cupcake. Ruined. When it comes to the Knicks, you're always wrong.
Okay.
You're always wrong.
About the Knicks?
Yes, you're wrong.
Really?
Like you, because your love gets in the way with your opinion.
You didn't have to go there.
Well, I am going to go there, Steve, because you need to
hear. Who's your team? Who's your team,
Well, that's neither here nor there.
Exactly.
First of all, my organization, the organization, first of all. I just want to say that I love coming here. You know, when I come here, you guys are really, really cool. About me doing my thing. And it may be because I'm better than you at your jobs. I don't know, okay? The fact that I'm a walking almanac. The fact that I don't wake up. I ask for respect.
Don't point at me.
I ask for respect.
What's going on, people? I am Kevin Hart, a.k.a. Mr. Comedic Rockstar. This is season two of Cold as Balls. The tub is colder, and my balls are bigger, too. Look, I got two big balls. Ooh, Isaiah Thomas. You got to be shitting me. Hey, white hand, how you doing today?
Good, man. Good for you.
What are those?
You talking about my trunks?
Oh, sure.
I'm doing a whole new thing season two. Season two, I'm heavy Euro. So I do a lot of trunks that come above my knees.
Yeah, those ain't it.
Yeah, no, I used to do that, but I'm changing.
They make you look a little
taller.
Smaller.
No, they actually make me look taller. Get in, man. All right. Ooh, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Cold as Balls. I'm not by myself, I'm with Isaiah Thomas.
My guy.
Holy shnikes. White hand, you like Isaiah Thomas? Yeah, yeah, I know you do. Let's get right into it,
let's
man.
Do it, let's do it.
1994, you guys swept the Lakers. What did it feel like to finally beat Magic Johnson? You, the Bad Boys, Bill Laimbeer, Dennis Rodman, Joe Dumars.
Hold on.
How did you do it?
I'm definitely not that Isaiah Thomas.
Well, everybody changes as life goes on, so.
94, I was 5 years old, so I don't even know if I even watched that series.
Explain that.
I'm a lot younger than that guy.
Give me a second. Did somebody give me the wrong notes? Guys, that's a lot to take in. All right, well, I think that I'm gonna ask the question everybody else wants to know, which is, who in the f- are you? And why are you here?
I'm the younger one.
You are the younger one.
I'm the younger one.
Okay, you and Isaiah, do you guys have a relationship?
Yeah, yeah, that's one of my mentors, somebody I met back when I was in college, so I talked to him a lot.
You know what's crazy? He had a doll. Like, you know how them players got that thing. You got that.
You know, being small, we gotta have...
Well, we're both not small.
You know, I mean, you're
speak
small.
Speak for yourself.
I'm normal height.
Well, you... We're two different versions. I'm big petite. That's where I'm at.
Yeah.
Now, before we get into that, whether the me being bigger than you, that doesn't matter to me. I don't want you to think that
I'm sitting here as a guy. It's like, I'm better than you because I'm bigger than you. I'm not that guy. Were you named after Isaiah Thomas?
I was. So there's two sides to it.
Okay.
I tell you, there. My dad was a big Laker fan from Los Angeles, California. He made a wager with his friend that if the Detroit Pistons beat the Lakers, he'll name his son Isaiah. And on top of that, my mom grew up in church. She liked the name, but she wanted it spelled the biblical way. So there's two sides to it. That's why it's spelled a little different.
Well, that's a great combination of addiction and Christ. That's what that is. That's a great combination.
Yeah, that was.
All right, you know what? We're about to get deeper into the tub. I don't like the fact that right now your fashion game is a step above mine, you know? My stylist keeps me right. White hand. Give me my headband. There we go. That's what I'm talking about.
Okay.
Yeah, I just figured we gonna be here. Huh? Yeah,
might as well.
Yeah. Sit down, man.
Them shorts in.
Let's sit down. Oh, yeah! Can you fit in there, little guy?
I hope you don't drown. You're like the only person I can say small jokes to.
Ah, well, you know what? This is the time to get them off, man. And I want to thank you for coming here, too, man. I know the craziest thing with doing the show is people's schedules, but the fact that you were willing to miss the playoffs to join me today says a lot about who you are as a friend. Let's talk draft day.
You know when I was drafted?
You were down.
Oh, my God. I was the last pick of the whole draft.
Of the whole draft?
The last one. Like, people are going home.
Time out.
60th pick.
60th pick?
Longest day of my life.
Ooh, we're about to get somewhere. Did you still go on the stage?
I wasn't even there.
Well, nobody was.
Exactly.
What's that feeling, though? You get drafted, and now that you're drafted, it's not the number, it's not where you want to be, but you're still going to the NBA.
Yeah, so the feeling was like, I was happy, because like that's always been my dream to hear my name called in the NBA draft. But on the other side of it, I was kind of frustrated because I felt like I outplayed the guys drafted in front of me.
Yeah, 100%. And I mean, does height play a major factor in this?
Oh, for sure. And the NBA height is...
Literally, that's it.
That's why there's not too many of us.
Of us.
I seen you get the MVPs in the celebrity game, so you're part of the fraternity.
And it's sad because they act like we don't exist.
Yeah.
So, 60th, who drafted you?
The Sacramento Kings.
God damn, can it get worse? Holy sh! You gonna tell me I'm 60th and I gotta go to Sacramento?
The Sacramento Kings.
Why didn't you want to stay in Sacramento?
Shoot, they didn't offer me anything.
Them sons of you, mother! You hear that, Daryl? Cause it's one of us, Daryl. Bam, bam. I guess you don't have this problem, do you? Because he's not one of us. I swear Daryl doesn't support me.
Well, he doesn't either.
Well, neither one of them really talk to me much. The only one that's really my friend is White Hand. White Hand, I know me and you cool. Yeah. So, right now, Phoenix is now an option.
So Phoenix, I signed with Phoenix.
Mm-hmm.
I'm near half the year before trade deadline comes.
Yeah.
Get traded, the last second of the trade deadline.
Yeah.
To Boston.
To Boston.
Where it all starts.
Favorite teammate?
Probably Marcus Smart.
Marcus Smart. Shout out to Marcus Smart. F*** everybody else.
Nah, I didn't say that.
You technically
did. No. All of those guys are my guys.
That's not what you said.
Nah.
I asked you, and you said Marcus Smart, and you didn't say anything about anything else. You got it. Right? Point guards in the NBA. Where do you put yourself at right now?
I'm one of the top players in the world, not just point guard.
Shit.
Oh, for sure.
That's right. You, Croatia.
For sure.
Right? NBA, give me your top five point guards right now.
I'm one, for sure. Steph Curry. This is actually no order. This
no
is just
order?
Five. I'm one though, but no order after that. Steph Curry.
Okay.
Westbrook.
Okay.
John Wall. Damian Lillard, he's pretty good.
You got you, then Steph Curry number two. You got Westbrook number three. Then he's like that bum, number three. Then you said John Wall number four, and you said he hit a wall. Damian Lillard.
Yeah.
All right, so let's cut to the chase. You don't like Kyrie Irving.
Oh my God, I forgot about Kyrie. No, Kyrie's third.
Too late.
Nah, for sure.
Too late.
No, Kyrie got game.
Well, who's bumped out?
John Wall.
Bye-bye, John. Playoffs. Tooth gets knocked out. Let's talk about one of your toughest moments in basketball right here. Did you have a mouthpiece on?
Nah.
I've never wore a mouthpiece though.
What an
I never wore a mouthpiece.
Well, you get on a motorcycle, you ain't gonna put on a helmet because you're too cool.
I'm not that guy.
What I'm getting at is that he deserved it.
What?
You know, a missing tooth changes your profile.
Oh,
completely.
It changes everything.
You ever see somebody that's missing a side tooth and you don't realize how they smile, man, and you instantly stop having a good time?
They smile way too big.
Yeah, you're like, ah! They're like, ah! Hey, man, what the f***?
Yeah, I was that dude. At?
Let's talk life after Boston right now. Let's talk the trade, man.
So going to Cleveland?
Yeah.
It was a tough situation because it caught everybody off guard.
It caught me off guard.
No warning, no nothing.
Jesus
Christ. That's the business.
The business of the game. Was it tough because of how random it was?
I poured my heart into that city in mm-hmm. Boston and mm-hmm. gave them everything I had. So that was tough to depart that situation.
At this point, was there any veteran that came to your aid to explain the business side of it?
So I mean, not really. Everybody reached out though. Like all the, I mean, former players on the team, players in the organization, because everybody was surprised. But you understand it, that it's a business and you just try to keep pushing. Keep
grudge going. At this point, is there a grudge?
Nah, I'm good. It was, I was very upset.
Okay.
Yeah, I was mad.
You get to Cleveland right now. All right, you with the quote unquote greatest player on the planet right now. Yeah. You're with LeBron James. Greatest player second to you, okay? Right now, you finally get the chance to go on the court. What happened with that, with the chemistry with you and the team?
It just didn't click for whatever reason. It was a brand new team. We had 8 new players.
Okay.
And then you have your main players coming in the middle of the season. It's hard to adjust. It wasn't nothing personal. It mm-hmm. just, for basketball purposes, it didn't work out.
All right, we're about to get deeper into the tub. Take your stool out and give it to White Hand. White Hand, stool coming. I don't ever take my stool out of fear of going too deep.
Here you go, White Hand.
We're now in Los Angeles, California, the city of the Hollywood's finest.
Yeah.
Stars like myself.
Yeah.
You go to the Lakers. Lakers aren't a team that's contenders right now. Jesus Christ, this guy was just at the top. Whoops, wait a minute. I just slipped on a banana peel. Now I went backwards. How do you feel about Los Angeles?
It's a young team, so mm-hmm. you gotta go back into that mindset of just developing these young guys.
How did it feel having LeVar Ball on your team?
I haven't seen LeVar Ball yet. I've been waiting to see
him. Are you serious?
Yeah.
You haven't seen him?
I haven't seen him. I think he's overseas. But really? Like,
so he's coaching the Lakers from overseas? Is he? How does he do that?
He FaceTimes us.
LeVar Ball has been on Coach's Ball. He's a good dude. He has nothing but love for his kids. What about Lonzo? You feel like Lonzo's a talented player?
Lonzo has a bright future. And the dope thing about him, he's a humble kid. Like
doesn't he rap?
He does do that.
Yeah.
He does do that.
Good
so he's always trying to rap, but
good
he's
you,
definitely
man.
A young kid in LA.
Yeah, so, good for him. Know. And rapping always goes good for basketball players. Shaq, Kobe, Lonzo.
Lonzo, who
yeah,
else?
They always do well.
You've been asking me a lot of questions.
Well, it's because it's my show.
I'm just saying. I got a few questions for you.
Fine. Shoot it.
Who was my son's favorite celebrity?
Easy question with an easy answer. Kevin Hart.
Hell no.
It's a good kid. He didn't say who was!
Kevin Durant. So it's close.
Who likes Kevin Durant?
KD, they love who?
What type of household is this?
They watch Jumanji, though, so they... Could you get him to meet The Rock?
Yeah, sure. And I'm gonna tell The Rock to punch him in the goddamn face. Right on sight.
What's my favorite pregame meal?
Easy. Cocaine.
Put the ice in there. Hell no.
All right, I thought the athlete.
Hell no, that was in the 80s.
Now, before we go, one thing that I think was dope was the tribute video that they did for you in Boston.
Come on, man.
Okay, what? I think it was a great thing.
First off, there was no damn tribute video. I got traded a day before I went back to Boston, so I couldn't
God damn it. Somebody, you really gotta give me my notes. Well, you know what? You're going to get one today.
I've been waiting.
Well, here it comes. Oh, shit. Hold on. God damn it. Jack, you put too many in there. I got major shrinkage. I told you I'm sick of that because when I watch the playback, I can tell. All right. What I want to do... Stop it. Stop what you're doing. Son of a... He gets me every time. Ladies and gentlemen, in the ball.
I want you to stand up and clap your hands and stomp your feet at a rapid pace, because we are about to honor a legend, a man that is not the biggest man, but he's a man that stands at the height of 5'2" and 2 inches. I'm talking about Mr. Isaiah Thomas. Get on your feet and give him the love that he deserves.
Isaiah, stand up. This is your moment. Everybody, stand up. Come on, Isaiah, stand up.
Hold on. Stand up.
That's right, crowd. Give it up. Clap for Isaiah Thomas.
That's you, white hand. Clap. White hand, can you do something? There you go. Hey, Daryl. Bam, bam. Right here. Give him one of these. Yeah, guys, go back here. Go back here. That's how we're gonna sign off. Ready? There you go.
Yeah! Thank you, Boston! We love you!
Thank you.
Keep it going till he walks out, guys.
That's what I'm talking
about. Come on, Z. Oh, man.
Keep it going, guys. Look at that. Keep the tribute going, guys. God damn it. Daryl, move your hands like you goddamn happy. It's a tribute video. Look at Bam Bam and look at what you're doing. It don't look the same. God damn it. Good job, guys.
Hi, I'm Kevin Hart. Unless you hate laughter, click and subscribe. And if you do hate laughter, then you're a monster.